Dr. Sharma, Dr. Panigrahi. I was told two introductions of Dr. Panigrahi. One was he's a former MLA, but other one was he's a medical doctor. To me, the medical doctor is more important because one of my granddaughter, when she asked me whether she should go for engineering or she should go for medicine, I told if you go for engineering, one bridge collapse will kill 1,000 people. But if you become a medical scientist, at least you can save a couple of lives. And she happened to be a medical doctor from Odisha. And I have some good old friends, Dr. Gard, Dr. Shivatsan. I'm meeting them after a long time, distinguished participants and friends. Let me first say that Odisha is not a new place for me because I'm a student of Odisha. And every state that I go contributes something to my life. I always say that Bengal made me teacher, Gujarat made me a professor. But silent world, Odisha contributed something very interesting. I was never a good student because I had no such interest at all. Not the capability. But when I came here, I got a very good number of extraordinary professors of philosophy, psychology, and so on. In 1 year, they established in me what it says in Nike, you can do it. So these professors instilled in me, you don't need to be an ordinary student, you can do it. So Odisha changed me. Whatever is my biota, it is after coming to Odisha. And a very interesting thing that is, we write, there's a very beautiful paper, why teacher is so important. I remember when my village school was celebrating 75th anniversary, so there was a alumni association meeting, they asked me to chair. I thought, all the time I'm chairing only. So I asked one of my students, who was the first student, who is a medical doctor. I said, why don't you chair? He agreed, he was very happy that I have asked him to chair. He told me in 1964, 1st August, my first class, what did I say the first sentence? I said, my God, what a dangerous thing. Fortunately, it was a positive sentence. He said, you told us that today you ask any question in mathematics, I'll solve, but from tomorrow onwards, we'll reverse it. So teacher is a very unusual kind of profession because we talk, we don't know what remembers. Here is my gentleman, can you stand up? He comes to me and he says, sir, I'm your student. He's a principal of a college in 2004 he went. 6th November, whatever I taught him, he has taken the note and he has brought that copy here. I took a photograph. The biggest pride of a teacher is wherever we go, we have students. And since I teach from school students to principals and vice chancellors, wherever I go, I get a student and that's the biggest pride. Coming to what we're going to talk about is the 4th Foundation Day of the state. I really feel humble for the role. Just as I thank Dr. Mohapatra for inviting me, but I don't appreciate his intelligence so much because this is not the occasion where a person of my stature should have been invited. He should have invited people with much larger stature. We are only, you know, scholars doing research, writing books, talking. But these are occasions when VIPs should be there. I was trying to remember my MP from here, I'm not able to remember. He was my minister from Sambalpur. Who do you know? He was a medical doctor again. Congress MP. Boy, that's right. Because he was my minister. I was at that time holding office in the SEC position. It's very important to see what Dr. Mahapatra told, that in such a short period, how the universe has grown. We, the management scientists, we classify institutions to four stages of growth. First is called the stage of incubation. Second is called the period of rapid growth. Third is called the period of stability. Fourth is called period of decline. Now, what he has done, he has actually brought in period of rapid growth inside incubation. 4 years is actually, according to our international research, 4 to 5 or 6 years is the period of incubation. After that starts the rapid growth, which takes about 10 years. Then it gets stabilized. And decline, one good thing about Indian institutions, it never gets closed down. So even it's decline, it remains at the decline stage, but continues. So it continues to produce poor quality people. When you talk about the UGC, Government of India is talking many things. I think they are talking not from their intelligence but from their hats. When you say we are 25.8 GER and we are talking of 30% GER, do we realize what is this 4.2% means? This 4.2% means 44 lakh students. And GER is essentially a wrong concept. GER is a gross enrollment ratio where there is no prerequisite. Primary education is the right one. Here you have prerequisite. Prerequisite is higher secondary. Here the right statistics is transition rate. What percentage of students are transiting from higher secondary education to? I mean, not only because today I am not on job, but when I was on job, I used to tell the minister that these are all wrong. Now the question is, why do we get 42 lakhs? Because already Indian transition rate is almost 65%. For a developing country, 65% transition rate is extremely high. When you talk of 52%, OECD countries have reached the universalization, that's about 75%. But then, secondary education base is very large. As mentioned, I was chairman of the CAB subcommittee on secondary education. India's secondary education base is very small. In my book I have written, madam, as I said, don't bother about, I see you as a doctor and not as a politician. That primary education is a primary concern of politics. Higher education is of higher concern for politics. Secondary education is of secondary importance. I have been member of planning commissions, working committees. I mean, hardly anything is left for secondary education. Without realizing that without secondary education, you can't build higher education. Dr. Armaji Desai, former chairperson of UGC, he wrote a paper on one of my books on infrastructural linkages. That higher education provides teacher to school education provides students for higher education. So you cannot have a quality system unless both are of quality. What will you do if you, for example, somebody talks of St. Stephen's or Presidency College of Calcutta or Avenser? I was incidentally in Avenser just 2 months ago, but I realized it is not the same Avenser that I used to know 50 years ago. I hope you agree with me. If you don't agree, don't get hurt. Yes, I have my own pride. Or Cotton College of... Now the question is, they are good because they get good students. St. Stephen's, what is your marks, entry marks, 100%? Presidency College. If you put brilliant students into one place, they will automatically grow. They don't need teachers. They need good library, good laboratory, and somebody to encourage them. Now, problem with the government is they are putting a lot of regulation that these are the courses you cannot run in distance education. But expand the GER. The education secretary, almost every alternate day, is in Dr. Srikant Mahapatra or Dr. Garg's old university, IGNO. What will the IGNO do? Question today is, we have got 42,000 colleges. If you divide 42 lakhs to 42,000 colleges, basically, it comes to 100 students have to be enrolled extra in every college. private universities have taken over 57% of total number of students. So government has been relieved a lot of financial load. But when I was chairman of the speaky committee or other committees, when I recommend to the government, why do you look down upon the private universities? They are doing a good job. We are saying they are not doing research. Give them the incentive. Project-based research grant will give you. ICSSR, ministry, UGC, all of them have project-based university grant. Why not to the private university? Because it's project-based. Now, unfortunately, there are a lot of this kind of problem. The other important thing which is coming up is online education, which is necessary, which Professor Mahapatra also told. In fact, I'll talk to Dr. Mahapatra in details. I have developed an online test on employability skills. Students who are going out of the college, are they employable? The test can be taken on the mobile. And you get 10 different skills, take the test, mobile will immediately show you a certificate. Of course, you may not be able to print it, but you can go to somewhere else to get it printed. When you talk about open and distance education and particularly the outcome-based learning, which I'll come, a few things which is very important, which unfortunately the formal education system does not understand. Yesterday I was talking to Dr. Garg. He rightly mentioned that the vice chancellors of open universities are selected by people from the formal institutions. Resultantly, they don't understand what are the dynamics of a system. Firstly, it's seamless. I don't know why Government of India has to say that Odisha State University cannot enroll students outside Odisha. Why does the Odia children go who are working somewhere else? It's a wrong policy. There are a lot of Odia children. I mean, the society that I'm there, almost every, many of them are from Odisha. Learn whatever one wants to learn. This is a very important question. Because otherwise we have physics, chemistry, mathematics. If I wanted to learn physics with history, I cannot do that. I mean, myself chairman of National Open School, and we had all those advantages. When the question came about mathematics, I hope you know that 80% of the children who fail in secondary, 80% who fail in mathematics, English and science. When this debate came up, I asked the ministry, who is important, my daughter or mathematics? He said, what do you mean? I said, for me, my daughter is important, not mathematics. I'm a mathematics teacher, I'm a qualified mathematics person. What do I do with differential calculus, integral calculus? Except adding up or paying to the vegetable vendor, I don't use it. I don't know it anymore. I mean, doctor sitting, or contemporary brain research teaches us that brain has got a beautiful waste management system. It has seen that this fellow does not use physics, does not use mathematics. You know, I'm basically a professor of management. So it has removed all that. I have only left me sense of physics. So when Dr. Garg, a distinguished professor of physics, he talks to me on physics, I'll understand it quickly. But if he asks me, I will not be able to answer. Well, my sense of physics will make me a fast learner. Now, learn the way one wants to learn. One of the important points that is important when you come to outcome-based education, we are no more talking about how do you learn. We are talking about learning outcome. So, learn the way one wants to learn. If somebody wants to learn lying down, perfectly all right. Somebody wants to learn jumping, it's perfectly all right. Many of the children you must be watching, they do serious mathematics. Kaan mein phone laga hua hai, wahan pe gaana aa raha hai. We could not do it in our times. It was concept. So what is important in open learning is we are not bothered about learning process. We are bothered about learning outcome. So that every individual, we call it in our language, individuation. Learn anytime. I remember, I don't know whether you will remember, Professor Amlal Parikh, Vice Chancellor of Gujarat Vidyapeeth, he was chairman of all of the committees of IGNOU, I was there, but he was actually taking a course from IGNU, from another department, a vice chancellor. He was taking course from one department and chairing another department. That is the important point, that anybody can take any course, any time, learn anywhere. One doesn't need to have necessarily a place to study. Not at any place. For example, when you look back, when you are school students, Bengali and English, I would finish the course in 2 months, but mathematics, it may take 12 months, 14 months, 15 months, I don't care about it. But teacher will not take the examination. So I'll have to wait for all the year, by the time I forget my English and Bengali also, and don't learn mathematics. Now in open and distance education, like in National Open School, we had every 6 months there was an opportunity. And now there is a provision on online examination on demand. Your student says, sir, I finished it, I want to get the, fair enough. Because everything is available on online, and there is a repository in which my grade is deposited. Learn from teacher and institution of your choice. Now this was not there. Recently, as they will be familiar, Commonwealth of Learning and Athabasca University was offering a course on technology-enabled learning. I come from a village in Howrah, and I work with primary school teachers, 125 primary. Some of them took a course from Athabasca University, got the certificate, who cannot even dream to go to Athabasca or Canada, and they are continuing interacting with the teacher, I am forgetting the name. IIT Bombay, they took a course on animation. Now, distance education has brought in that enormous flexibility. You learn whatever you want to learn, you learn whenever you want to learn, and so on. So the whole difference, shifting, is teaching to learning, it is self-learning, and increasingly accepting what physics people taught us long ago, self-organizing learning system. Every human being is capable of learning. 3 years ago, I was asked by Commonwealth of Learning to do an evaluation of technology-enabled learning in Commonwealth countries, and there was no budget for travel. So my only budget was sit in the computer and do it. I learned the new skills and I could do it. So that self-organizing, in fact, important point that we need to understand, and that is a message to Dr. Srikanth, who is very dynamic. The open and distance education doesn't create learned people. It creates learners. Because the students have to be self-learning. And the moment they are self-learning, they will be able to learn throughout their life. So lifelong learning, which we talk about, generally speaking, majority of the people are educated or learned people. Learning people are very few. What is the difference? Learned people is in the past. PhD is the first and the last research. Very often, we get very irritated when the medical representative comes to the doctors, because they take away our time. So someday somebody asked me, I said, do you realize who is educating the doctor about the new developments in drugs? Now that's a mechanism. So in many hospitals what they have done is they have fixed a time, only 4:30 to 5 medical representatives. Now whole question is the learning opportunities are multiple. Are we exploiting them? Important point is the moment you go into learning outcome, why, although IGNU and others are claiming, as Dr. Srivastava was talking to me, I'll say sorry, this is not correct. Learning outcome, unless it is linked to taxonomy of educational objectives, it will not happen. Most of you are familiar, taxonomy we have derived from biology, basical classification. This I am skipping. Very often our educated community, they talk only about Bloom's taxonomy, but they don't realize that there are many other taxonomies. One is Ganey. This is Merrill's descriptive component display theory. This is another taxonomy. This is Big Sand College taxonomy. I'm just trying to draw your attention so that people know that these are not the only, Bloom is not the only person. But Bloom has had the maximum impact on outcome-based learning. His first book came out in 1956. Very often, when I ask people who wrote Bloom's taxonomy, they say Benjamin Bloom. I say, how do you know it? So my next question often is, who wrote Kothari Commission report? At least that is Indian. It was not by D.S. Kothari. It was by J.P. Naik. J.P. Naik was memo secretary. Because who writes is the one who can write. J.P. Naik is a great writer. D.S. Kothari is a great professor of physics again. Now, this was the actually group which is working. I'll skip this because it is not only cognitive domain, but since we are talking about cognitive domain, we'll come back to that. This is the first Bloom's taxonomy in 1956. It says, level of learning is knowledge, comprehension, application, analysis, synthesis, and evaluation. But this was questioned. After Merrill's component display theory, Bloom's taxonomy was changed into a matrix structure. On one side, knowledge dimension. On the other side, remember, understand, apply, analyze, evaluate, create. It was synthesis was replaced by create. I have my own difference of opinion with metacognition. To me, metacognition is knowledge dimension. It's a cognition of cognition. So it should be actually on the other dimension. So normally in my So this is Bloom's revised taxonomy. Coming to outcome-based education, it has these five pillars: learning outcome, curriculum design, learning material, learning design, assessment of learning outcome. The major difference that ODL will be facing the challenge is learning outcome. The other day before coming, yesterday, two professors were arguing with me, you mean before the syllabus, the learning outcome? I said, your syllabus has to be according to learning outcome. If I say from Gurgaon that I want to go to Sambalpur, so my goal will decide how do I travel. My travel cannot decide whether I'll reach Sambalpur or I'll reach somewhere else. Now, important point is that here, the pole star is learning outcome. And this is important. I was just talking to another Dr. Professor Panda. The whole question came in the medicine field. Spady's book is a very famous book, Outcome-Based Education, that you say you are a surgeon. Can you actually do the procedure? So question is, you give the evidence that you are actually a surgeon. Washington Accord is much more for accreditation, uniformity of standards. That was 1989, little earlier than Spady's work. But medical field has given the lead in terms of this domain. Certain things, of course, I'll have to skip because that is part of workshop. Learning outcome is a proof or evidence of learning. If I say I'm a graduate, I must be able to give evidence. What should a student be able to do to demonstrate his or her learning? Like, for example, today we are saying 80% of the engineers are not employable. I did a study sponsored by Government of India. 4,500 teachers on service. 32% are found to be not qualified to be teacher. They have a qualification, but not fit to be teacher. Because teacher is not the one who communicates knowledge anymore. For that we don't need teacher anymore. We need teacher for the affective domain, to encourage, to inspire. When you talk of these learning outcomes, it is divided into series of things. Like first is graduate attribute. What is the indication of the graduate? It has linked with the mission or vision of your university. When you say graduate, I am a graduate of Calcutta University, I am graduate of St. Stephen's College, what is the proof? what are the attitude, what are the attributes, and that attribute is seen 10 years from the graduation. So that way, what is actually left to you? Second important thing is program educational outcome, which is roughly checked after 3 to 5 years when somebody is already in the job. Program outcome, end of the program, whether it is 6 months, 9 months, 1 year, 3 year, at the end of the program. And the course outcome. For example, when IGNU and others are claiming, whole question is, as you would see the material from Odisha, a course comprises several blocks. Each block comprises several units. Now the problem is that every unit has a learning objective, whether it is stated in learning outcome format or not is another question, but definitely one step ahead. But there is no block learning outcome. And what happens to the 5 blocks put together is a course outcome. Several courses put together, I mean, IGNU had a course on course called MAD, Master of Arts in Distance Education. Now, it has several courses. So, if you take one course like research methodology, it has got 5 blocks. Each block has got 5 modules. So, 25. But what you get is only unit learning outcome. Now, here comes the biggest challenge for open and distance education, because it is little more complicated. It has unit outcome, block outcome, course outcome, program outcome, and then this program specific outcome, unfortunately, it is NAC's invention. International literature doesn't talk about program specific outcome. It talks about program outcome and graduate attributes. Now the question is that at the moment, if you look at this, unit outcome is a courseware author. When you talk of block end, block outcome at the block end, course team, several people, those who are familiar with open and distance education, for them it is easy to understand, but for those, like in block there could be several units, so each unit is written by one person or two persons, together they make the course team. Then course end, that is course team. Program end, that's a department, institution, like IGNU or Odisha State Open University. And when you go to graduate attribute, they are already on the job. So what is the employers, what the employers are talking about? Now what is important is to learn to plot, this is actually subject of workshop which when I do, that these are the remember, understand, apply, analyze, where, and then program outcome, unit outcome, course outcome, and so on and so forth. Now, that tabulation of 2D levels of learning outcome is something which has not been done in distance education despite the claim. It is little, then course, the outcome mapping. For every one of them, we need to do the outcome mapping, level of cognition for course, CO, block. Fundamental question is what would a student be able to do to demonstrate that he or she remembers, understands, applies, analyzes, creates at the end of a particular course. Now this is something what is very important in case of distance learning. When I was doing chairman National Open School, I asked one very senior lady, I said, why don't you take a course from here? He said, how can I at my age? I said, tumko cooking aati hai? He said, of course, she is a good cook. I said, that's practical. Only thing you do not know, whether you are maintaining your nutrition, hygiene, and couple of other scientific dimensions. But that part is the theory, you have to learn it. 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 For example, Odisha is also fish-eating. We normally like when the fish is very brown, fried. Doctors will say fish is soft protein, and red meat they will ask us not to take. Soft protein when you fry, Are you getting the soft protein or are you getting the ashes? Unless you remove the coating. If you remove the coating, then you are losing your taste. Now that is the science component is one and practice component. Almost every lady, they have got the practice component very strong. Some of them are very good cook, but they may not know the scientific aspect of it. Similarly, block and unity outcome. The whole problem with the course outcome or block, that is how to accumulate. So at the end of program like certificate, diploma, graduation, post-graduation, how do you prove these kind of things? This is a sample graduate output. I've given my paper. I have not circulated the paper for simple reason. I use actually a dictation software instead of writing with hand. With hand, if it is 30 words a minute, I can achieve 100 to 110 words a minute. But there are howlers in it. So I have to read it again. That time I did not have because I just came from Coimbatore and then came back here. These are graduate attributes. That this is just a sample, Deakin, Oxford, Adelaide. The decision, discipline specific knowledge, you can see it almost common, deep discipline, academic literacy, communication, digital literacy, critical thinking, problem solving, self-management. Now the self-management is not a cognitive domain, it's an affective domain. Do I have critical awareness about myself? Now these graduate attributes are developed not through courses. But courses and many others, what we talk about, the formal learning, informal learning and incidental learning. Our maximum amount of learning is incidental learning. To give you two examples, when somebody asked me, I asked a question, are you a parent? He said, yes sir. Which school did you go to learn parenting? Is parenting more difficult than geography or physics? Everybody is parenting. I said, so more difficult thing you could learn without going to school, and a less difficult thing like physics or geography, between computer, incidentally, Srikant, your phone is here. Ye kiska hai? Acha. If it is a better one, then I'll exchange. Good. Now the question that is, the technologist must be able to respond. Which one is a more complicated system, the laptop or the phone? Which one is more complicated technology? Essentially the phone. We did not go to take any course. And all of us are using. I still remember I went to Raipur for a marriage. And I was staying at a home, somebody's home. A child of hardly 2-year-old girl, she just heard a voice. Straight from bathroom, dripping water, she came and picked up my phone and started teaching me how to see the photo gallery. Her mother was asking her, please come, let me mop you up, dress you up. She's not bothered. On my phone, she's teaching me how to see photo gallery. Imagine. Now, we are talking of a generation who are phone generation. USAID asked me for a project on Bihar on how to train 5 lakh people without taking the teachers out of the school. I had no choice. I gave them phone-based technology, phone-based delivery, which now World Bank is funding. Interesting point is when I talk to Chief Secretary or the Secretary of Education, they said, no, no, sir, Bihar is a backward state, they don't have phone. I said, okay. I went to remote areas to a diet. I asked any pastors, I said, how many of you have got phone? Everybody raised the hand. I said, don't raise the hand, show me the phone. Everybody had a phone and mine was the oldest variety. Today, I mean, this is for the Vice Chancellor's way, we talk about 5,000 rupees, the baseline for any Android phone. That can take care of it. You can buy the phone for 15,000, 60,000, 70,000, but 5,000 is the baseline. And we are doing a research on OSOU Yesterday he was very happy to refer to that one and NSOU, Calcutta. I went to remote areas because I come from village, so I like villages more. So I asked him a question, and which I wrote in the report. They have done a great job, but they don't know how to market it. That's what I say, please learn from the Prime Minister, whether you do things or not, don't do, but at least learn to market. Now the whole question is, they don't know how to market. When I told the student, you have phone? Yes, sir. Except one girl did not have. So I told the girl, you sit next to the person who has got a phone. I said, just check up NSOU mein kya hai. NSOU is Netaji Subhash Open University. They found out, I said, are there videos? They said, yes, sir. They're so excited that they stopped talking to me. They were busy seeing the video. Now, this enormous resource, and then they started questioning the study center authority. Aap logon ne humko bataya kyun nahi hai? We have been complaining about not getting the material, and the material is here. I said, this is a genuine complaint to the Vice Chancellor. Ki aap logon ne humko bataya kyun nahi? Now, here comes a major difference when we talk of curriculum design in OBE. Curriculum has to be decided not on the basis of epistemology or on the basis of structure of knowledge. It has to be decided on the basis of what outcome you want to achieve. So create the curriculum guided by cover. And this is where we normally recommend competency-based education. So that, because you are developing competency, learning outcome is evidence, so competency. So develop the competency-based education. These are the learning outcome. In case of open and distance education, the major question is, learning material is the teacher. Here the teacher, physical teacher like I'm standing or Dr. Sharma standing has no value. How do you do the learning material preparation becomes extremely important here. And that is why learners learn through learning material, because we have done enough research that those who go to counseling session and those who don't go, there is no difference in their performance. So counseling does not have any necessary impact. It's a good socialization. And this tendency we need to understand. I was in New York State College and I found the college has no student. So I asked the principal, where are the students? They said, they come once in a while. I said, what about? He said, oh, they come for dating. I said, come for dating? He said, rest of the study, they can do it on phone, they can do it on technology, except dating they cannot do on technology. And remember, New York State College is not an ordinary institution. Now the whole world is changing and we are holding on to the old pattern. So, whole question for Dr. Mahapatra and others, what do you do with the learning material? I have seen many of the learning material. Here the learning material is the master. Premier Bodiel, I'll clip. There are a lot of articles. Those who are interested, they can go and read them. Normally, we are talking about that all students don't learn the same way. But every student can learn is an important way. That is the mastery learning of Bloom's later work. The reference point is that is where the Vice-Chancellors of Open University and other universities have to work on. People must understand different schools of psychology of learning, behaviorism, cognitivism, constructivism, connectivism, connectionism. Connectionism is the CMU paper's work. Connectivism, brain-based learning and taxonomies of educational objectives. For example, somebody was giving material to Professor Berg of Odisha State University. Now, you begin with an introduction. Whose psychology is this? It's from Ashubel. He's a cognitivist. He's an advanced organizer, preparing my mind to do. Then comes a series of objectives. It comes from Skinner, also it comes from Malcolm Knowles. Unless we know the psychologist, we don't know why are you doing it. Constructivism. For example, Odisha Open University has been asked for a lot of skill development. When you do the skill development, there has to be an artifact, there has to be a product, and that is collectionism. So unless we know Seymour Papert enough, it's collectionist. I have with me, I work with the village children. They have produced, I told them that this lawn you have to maintain yourself. So he said, I said, if you want to buy a grass cutter, you can do it. He said, sir, can we make it? I said, make it? And so, chalo, let me take a chance. I said, how much would it cost? 200 rupees, sir. I gave 200 rupees. They made a grass cutter and got an award from the state under Udan. And they sent me. It's a plain, and there are a couple of things, and they hold on. And now, in case of skill training, there's a lot of those kind of things will happen. There have to be demonstrated, as I told you about Spady's work. You are a surgeon, come to OT. So senior surgeons are there, so that he doesn't make a mess of it. And the surgeon has to prove that he has completed. If you remember, in Mahabharata, Arjuna was asked to pierce the eye of the bird. Only then he was said, okay, now you are qualified. So that is evidence of learning. So my submission would be that your teachers have to understand different schools of psychology. Not that, and interestingly, unlike formal system, open and distance learning, they make a blended learning out of all these schools. This is something which is important for us to remember, that open learning is being classified into five different generations based on learning material. The point I'm making, learning outcome and learning material are the two outstanding features of open and distance learning. First one is printed textual material and customized textbook, radio, television, but let me skip that one. In 1990s, it was telecommunication and internet-based learning, interaction and collaboration. But then, go back to Alvin Toffler, that on the same day, there are people in future, present and past. So that's true about the institutions. There are still people who are working on correspondence education, which was 1913's discovery. 2010 or 2020 is going to be online courses, MOOCs and OER. One very interesting thing that Dr. Mahapatra's team has done, a lot of OER, NSOU has done, maybe YCM OER, but nobody is using mutually the OER. If his OER is good, why should I make another? I'll use his OER and create a course. That is why it is OER. We are not using. So our mindset is not in 2020. Our mindset is 1813. Instructional learning designed to be built in, this is another point I'll suggest. I have seen a large number of videos of Odisha State Open University. Particularly the videos that I don't know the subject. Like for example, in management I specialize in OB, organizational behavior and HR. So what I did was I saw on financing and marketing. Beautifully done. But the problem is these are stereotype lectures. I had a long discussion with the Vice Chancellor of Calcutta University. The problem is that they have to depend upon the college teachers. College teachers, they are not used to writing, preparing what they are going to talk. I make films. I make almost 40 films I've made. I can produce a film in 3 days, but I need 15 days to write the script. Every details I work out. Because every word has a meaning, every visual has a meaning for me. For example, the kind of videos here, I found most of the 18 minutes, 20 minutes. Now, the way you have structured the learning material, print, textual material, can it be done? Whenever I make a film, I put first a 4 questions. And I asked the students that, can you find out answers to these four questions when you see my video? At the end, I repeat that question. Second important point, which many of you are familiar, at least I know Dr. Mahapatra, Dr. Shivatsana, very familiar, Dr. Gar. We call it bite-sized video, micro video. Video talk more than 10 minutes is sheer waste. Nobody listens. It's not possible. There's enough research worldwide. Best of the professor cannot hold attention. You can hold attention when you're partially present for 1 hour or more, but not on video. It's not possible. So if the same video that you are doing is broken into 5 or 6 micro videos in between certain exercises, so that the instructional design that you are doing in the print material, do it the same thing in the video material. Long ago, I published a paper in British Journal of Education Technology on multimedia, instructional design for multimedia. This is important. So, whole question today is a blended learning design, and that will make this, I'll cut this short, this is our work. We have 65 different learning tactics. My last point is about assessment of learning outcome. How do you assess? Now you are talking about unit outcome, block outcome, course outcome, program outcome. Now in unit, there are small activities like exercises, activities, etc., which can be done, which could be formative assessment. But there is nothing for the block. There is nothing for the course outcome. So this is something we need to figure out. How do you do it? There are different types of assessment. Now this is the outcome mapping. If this is the column in which, then 1, 2, 3, 4, so what is the thing that you are going to do? And let me come to this. So the moment UGC says you have to take the test in paper or pencil test, they are contradicting themselves. You cannot measure a skill on paper pencil. Why can't you ask them to do on computer simulation? Many of the things, for example, no pilot learns flying without simulation first. In China, I have seen every driver has to go through simulation driving first in their laboratory. I don't know, madam, in your field whether there is enough simulation. But simulation is a very important thing, which is a risk-free learning, which is necessary. When you are preparing something, so written test is not enough. Written test can manage what we call knowledge, understanding, lower order cognition. The moment you want to go to higher order cognition, it will be difficult. Task performance, quizzes, brainstorming, assignments, projects, practicals, demonstrations, simulation, computer-aided troubleshooting, tutorials. I mean, in the morning, I asked a plumber to come to my room in the hotel. I said, this whole has stopped, so please clean up. Well, I was taking the bath, so water was all around me, I was sitting inside. Very simple. The holes that are in the first circle has got blocked. Very normal. So he came, he cleaned up, and then, but when he cleaned up in the old style. He took a pin and one, which is not necessary. He should have opened it, dip it in acid, strike it, it will be cleaned up. But then he is not trained. I mean, what P.S. Devdar was trying to do some years ago. Problem solving, interview is a very important technique. Whenever you want to go to the depth, I'll share with you. I was appearing for my interview for lectureship in MS University of Baroda. So I had a friend of mine, very good friend, but very good competitor. So it's a question, who gets what? And we did not want to lose either of us. So I said, okay, you take to computer, I'll take to research, because there are two specialists. Yeah, I don't know computer. So what I did is I told them that the committee members also don't know computer. I'm talking about 1974. What you have to do, you have to drop new words, and they will keep on asking you new words and convert it into a class. And I decided to take them to multivariate analysis, which again the board will not know. When the board was absolutely convinced that I'm a genius, my teacher started asking me questions. And he goes into one step to another step to another step, what you call probing. A step came when I had to say, sorry sir, I won't go anymore. It's okay. So in the evening he called me, he said, good scolding, what are you doing? You are trying to befool the committee? Because you know they don't know this or no, but didn't you know that I'm sitting there? I said, but sir, you never asked question. Why did you ask question? He said, only to warn you I asked the question. Don't do it. I said, but sir, what is the impression? No, committee was very impressed. And you are at the top of the list. But the question is, only interview can go to the probing to the extent how much, how deep is the knowledge. Yesterday I was traveling with him. He's a computer professional. He was talking of PHP, Python and all that. Now, that's a great occasion for me to know if I knew enough. What is the depth of it? Whereas we don't do interview. PR assessment is another. PR assessment, product design and development, artifact as I mentioned to you, alumni assessment, employer assessment, self-assessment. So at the moment the assessment that you are doing is not good enough at all. And if UGC is talking about do skill development, do online but do paper pencils, they are talking rubbish. My advantage is I am not obliged like Professor Mahapatra. Firstly, I am retired and I am elder to all of them. In fact, the last chairman was my successor in NIPA. Multi-channel assessment, so whole question is how do you convert your assessment system into multi-channel assessment? I've only given few because there is no more space, but you have to expand that one and create the unit outcome, block outcome, course outcome. So you need to plot it. And that is how we need to create a new kind of a situation where the what we are trying to talk today is not enough when you go into that kind of a situation. The outcome-based education is picking up as a movement now. It will and should come in ODL. Now the government policy is to include ODL institutions also under NAC. You are lucky that you are not yet 5 years. And remember, NAC has 20 points on learning outcomes. I was recently in Coimbatore helping some other organization. Now, ODL institutions have to diligently try to do this because there are 20. More importantly, outcome-based education is a way to improve quality. Very often, it's very unfortunate. When I sit down in the car in the front seat, I put the belt. First thing, driver says, sir, iski jurat nahi hai. I said, I'm not putting it for the police, I'm putting it for myself. Now, we always see Misal, NAC is for quality. NAC is not for satisfying NAC visitors. NAC visitors are satisfied in many different ways. Many of you know, I don't need to say it in public. But NAC is for quality. What do you do to build up the quality rather than satisfying the NAC team? Now, it is implementing. So what is important is we need to implement without the regulatory authorities. Because many of the regulatory authority, I assure you, they have very little understanding. Because I've seen, not only seen, I've been involved in many of these kind of things. As far as I know, Odisha State Open was the first one in the country to initiate a discourse on outcome-based open distance learning. And this credit goes to Dr. Mahapatra for taking this innovative initiative. Because he is not the first university, he is one of the recent university, but he thought of ODL, OB in ODL, much earlier than many others. What others are doing, this is exactly where the difference between a leader and non-leader. Non-leaders justify whatever you say, they say, we are already doing. Leaders say, oh my God, here is an idea. They start taking out. I finish by saying that there are three kinds of learners. This is Swami Supadananda's categorization. One kind of learner is called dose ki tawa. Woh bhi kuch bhi do, ud jata hai. Second is called kamal ke patte. Very new idea, they romanticize, oh my god, beautiful thing, when the sun shines on that new drop, it shines, sparkles like a diamond. But with a small wind, the lotus leaf, and the lotus leaf remains whatever it is. So, after, and there is something called oyster. They wait for the opportunity. Many people, I mean, this is my 40 years of staff development experience, people have not developed because we have trained. Those who wanted to develop, they got idea from our program, they are the oysters. They look for an opportunity to learn. I mean, imagine this gentleman, 2004, he has maintained that copy. Most other people sell it under a Raddi. And he showed me, this is Dr. Mukhopadhyay on 6th November 2004. I mean, it's unbelievable for me. If somebody asked me, I may not be able to say it. Now, that, what is the difference between Dr. Mahabharata and others? That when there are many, dose ki tawa, and good number of kamal ke patte, there are few oyster. By taking this initiative, he has been the oyster. Only thing, I'll appeal to him on the fourth foundation day, that you don't need to be best in India. You can be best in the world. What is important is not imagining is the crime. Imagining is not the crime. And the point I often say, I have a great disliking for people who say practical, reality. To me, these are bad words. What is important is fantasy. Those of you who are from science, you know, whatever you read in 1960s as science fiction is no more fiction, they are all facts. And what we read as science fiction in 1960s, in 1910s, it was all fantasy. My submission is, those who are leaders like Professor Srikant Mahapatra, please ensure that you are able to inculcate fantasy and not practical. Thank you.